What's up, guys? Hobbo88 here, and welcome back to iRacing. And it's the Pro Trucks here at Charlotte on the Roval, which is a pretty decent combination for these trucks. The setup that we've got this week is extremely tight, very understeery, which is eternally frustrating. But the trucks around here, probably not a bad combination. I think better than some of the ones that we've seen already this season. A little bit less draft, which I'm keen about. Last week, Phillip Island was a bad week. We didn't really have an outright terrible result, but we didn't win anything. We sort of ran around outside the top three most of the night, and we struggled in the points, therefore have a very slim or slender lead in the championship over our teammate Posse coming into tonight. And so far in the practice sessions, my pace has not looked that great here, so we'll have to see how we go. I feel like it's a sort of track where anything can happen and probably will. So hopefully we can bag ourselves a good result and get a little bit more of an edge in that championship going into the next round. But anyway, guys, sit back, relax, and enjoy some Pro Trucks here at Charlotte on the Roval. So our absolutely horrible qualifying lap turned out to be good for second. Mitch on the pole by a couple of tenths. Aussie with an off track. Snell with an off track. So they're at the back, so we're in a really bad spot here for the initial launch on the outside, out of the final chicane and into the turn one. But I mean, at least we're at the front. We just got to try and not get wrecked here and hold on to a good spot. We're in a good position to make some championship points. Now, is Mitch going to go early? I doubt it. But he could. First look at what the draft is like. Oh, we made a big mistake. Oh, it's a big one. That was a very awful move. I'm expecting to probably cop some payback for that. We went in there so much harder than I was expecting. It's nice to be in a vehicle that can take so much curb so nicely, but I'm not gonna lie. Slow down. What? Let's see if these things are slow enough that they clear themselves. Doesn't look like it. We're gonna give up the lead right here. We're gonna have to. Oh, clear! Oh my goodness, I thought we were gone. That's a shame. We needed to probably hold that spot. Got our just deserves though, probably, for that. We learned a lesson though. It's not like the Pro Light trucks. The slowdowns don't clear themselves in these. That's the first slowdown I've got in all the practice and everything, too. Oh well, that's our first race. Posse's up to fifth, man, seriously. Good recovery from him from the back. That's a shame. Anyway, we'll take second. So a little bit of deja vu. Outside of the front row yet again for the start, the second race. Not really where I want to be. This time we've got a couple of faster dudes on the second row behind as well. Ryan in third anyway, who is very aggressive. So we've got to be careful this time. Yeah, same. The green flag. Try and block Ryan. We couldn't try and hold around the outside there with him lurking back there. Conceded that when he didn't have to there, I'm not quite sure why. But I was looking in my mirror and I see a car or a truck coming that I don't want to have to deal with in about a lap. Thanks for the follow. Coming to the white, we're nearly there, but you're never safe. These guys fighting behind will probably help. Aussie? Was that a big slowdown down there? Must have been. Oh, they're all dead behind us. Big crash. Mitch and Pozzy. I'm interested to see what happened there. But that is the perfect scenario for me. Oh, and they're still stuck on the fence, both of them. Oh, boy. We've got 9 laps coming up in the last race. We've got to just try and stay in front and not let them catch back up. They're going to be starting from the back. I feel for Pozzy. I feel for both of them, actually. Especially to my teammate. But it helps us and Snell out of this race as well. All the big rivals in the championship out of this race. So that's good news for me. But we've still got one more race to come yet. Plenty of time for us to make a mistake. Alright guys, third race. 9 laps this time, the final for the night. We're off pole, which is where we want to be. Mitch is not taken to the grid. He's in the pits. I don't know if he'll start from pit lane or not. If I was able to, I'd love to. Absolutely. But that's a big step. Alright, I want to try and get Sam into second here because, one, I feel like he's safer than Ryan, but, two, the Cowboy is an awesome dude, so I'm going to try and get him into second, so I'm going to do what Mitch did in the last race. I'll go early and hope that he spots it and can get into second behind me. And he does. Sam's a long time follower of mine, a very cool dude, so I wanted to try that to see if I could get him into second. And it worked. Exactly the same as the last race when I was in second and Mitch did that. Also saves me having to worry about potentially side by side into turn one. We just have to go and hope that we get lucky and can pull away enough that we're not threatened here and just drive this one to the win. The draft is strong, so we'll require something special to do that, but I don't know what happened to Sam. It's all gone wrong for him. Ryan's risky. Ryan's a bit of a wild card because he will just send it no matter what. Completely missed turn one. Already put the bumper on me. Depending what happens, I'd nearly be prepared to let him go and see if we can get him at the end again, rather than have him hassle all over the back of me and risk taking me out. Too many points on offer for us to get wiped out right here. He'll probably just go for it straight away here. No, that's it. This is it. Oh, big understeer. Oh, Snelly's in the pits again. He's had a bad night. Oh yeah, for sure. Well, we already had a narrow points lead coming into tonight over Posse. I expect to see that number 95 appear on the relative before this race is out, though. He'll salvage something from this if he doesn't get caught up in anything. But that second race will hurt him. Ryan's taking a heap of curb in that last chicane. I've been burnt by a slowdown there once already tonight. I don't really want to risk that again. Ryan's not above exceeding track limits to bridge a gap. You're not supposed to go more than two wheels off the racing surface. Two more to go. This is going to be awkward. Away with that. I was lucky that he bumped me right there on the corner exit and got me sideways there. It's perfect defense for the next corner. You got to slow down. Let's say. Oh man. Thank you for the follow. Kind of robs us all of a bit of a good finish right there. That was getting exciting. Well, I'm happy to take the win, but. Absolutely. I did it last year. Anyway, here we go, guys, through the chicane for the final time. And that's a win. Second quick in qualifying, second place in the first race, and then two wins to finish the night, so that cements our points lead again after last week that was not very good. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you're watching this back on YouTube, thanks for tuning in. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Hobbo88, twitch.tv/Hobbo88. Check out the live streams. Don't forget to join the Discord channel. Link is in the description below. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you in the next one.